What a joy it is to be with you once more, to bring to you a word to brighten your day as you go through the remainder of the week. To start off our presentation this morning, I would just like to take you on a journey with me. I look back at, you know, when I were in primary school. And, you know, in primary school, one of the things that my mom used to do is that when the term is coming to an end, she gave us all a challenge. If you bring home a particular grade point average, she would reward you with one or two things that you put on your list that you'd like for your Christmas gift. Now, sadly, I was born in December. So unlike those of you who receive a birthday gift and a Christmas gift, I get only one gift. You either get the one for the birthday or you get the one for the Christmas. So most often, you know, we celebrate the birthday, but the gift really and truly comes when Christmas comes. So the whole point is that, you know, every year we would do our best to ensure that we get the gift. So there was this one particular year that Huffy bicycles were the big thing. You know, if you don't have a Huffy bicycle and you're in primary school, you ain't in nothing. And we're not talking about the regular solid frame Huffy. We're talking about those with the shocks in the front and in the back. So when you hold the brake, you just stay bouncing and bouncing for a bit. And those cost, you know, like close to $500 at the time. So I told my mom that, you know, I will work hard to get that grade point average. And I did get the grade point average to get the Huffy bike. But the sad thing is, I got the grade point average to get the Huffy bike, but I did not got the bike. For a short discourse this morning, I've captioned it, "The Reality Behind the Appearance." I pray, most high and loving Father, indeed, O God, we thank you for this beautiful day. Father, we thank you, O God, for the blessings that you put on us, O God. And we thank you, O God, for molding us for a time such as this. Father, I ask, O God, that you empty me of self, O God, and anything that is not of you. Use me as you see fit, O Lord, and I pray that as you use me as your mouthpiece, that everything that I will see will be thus said your word. Be with us now as we journey. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. The reality behind the appearance. What a world we are living in today, where there are so many individuals working for the Lord, but not walking in the Lord. You might ask, Elder, how is this possible? But the thing is, there are many individuals busy doing all the things that they want to do for God, that they don't even stop and ask the Lord, Lord, what do you want me to do? They are so entrenched or entangled in their work that they forget all about who they are actually doing it for. The sad note is working for Christ can easily become a business that focuses on self. Perhaps they love the praise that they receive from being faithful and the good that they do, which motivates them to do even more. Or maybe they are addicted to the power of holding a church office, one that allows them to do everything their way. Or they love the respect and recognition that they receive for being such a godly leader, such a godly man or woman. But sadly, anytime ministry becomes all about you and not about God, you are no longer working for God, but for yourself. My friends, the reality behind the appearance. Are you working for God, or are you working for yourself? We have to be very careful that when we step out daily to do the work for God, that we maintain constant communication with God. Because if we don't do this, we are in danger of doing what we are doing, as nice it might be, for self. But thank God that in His Word, we have the reassurance and the guidelines by which we can follow. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 21 to 23, not everyone who calls out to me, Lord, Lord, enter into the kingdom of heaven. Only those who actually do the will of my Father in heaven will enter. On judgment day, many will say to me, Lord, Lord, we have prophesied in your name and cast out demon in your name and perform many miracles in your name. But I will reply, I never knew you. Get away from me, you who broke God's law. It is crucially important, my friends, that we do what God wants us to do. If we are not getting our assignment from God, then we can actually call it sin. What are you doing today? Is it for God or is it for self? The sad thing is that there are many of that is so wrapped up in doing the good deed. There are so many of us that is so wrapped up in doing what we perceive to be of God that we forget that we need to be communicating with God and not just doing it out of our feelings. The reality behind the appearance. A few months ago, I was given a gentleman a ride, and he asked me the same question. He said, Elder, what is the reality behind the appearance? Why are so many of us so caught up with doing our own things and not recognizing that what we are doing should be for God? Nothing that we have attained in our life is of ourselves. Our big degrees, our big house, the car that we drive, the job that we have, nothing that we have attained is because of ourselves, but it is because of God working through us. But the sad thing is that so many of us are so caught up with self that we are not recognizing that we are not doing the work of the Lord. But sadly, there is so many of us that is so busy, you know, with the food bank. We are so busy feeding the homeless. We are so busy going down the road and looking for those families that are struggling and tending to their needs, that we are not recognizing that we need to be communicating with God as we do these things. All these things are good, But are we doing it because God have impressed upon our heart to do it? Or are we doing it because when Elder Jerry goes down to Road Town and he goes into the ghetto and he give out 100 meal, you can hear it on the TV or in the newspaper. Oh, Elder Jerry Jones have just give out 100 meals there. Oh, Elder Jerry Jones have give out 1 million meals for the year. What is it? The reason why I do what I do. I'm here to tell you this morning, what I do is not about me. I am just a sinful being asking God for his saving grace each and every day. The Bible makes it clear that there will be many surprises when judgment day shall come, because there will be many individuals that be saying, I have prophesied in your name, I have cast out demons in your name, but still yet Jesus will say, depart from me, I know you not. Now it would be a really sad day that I've been speaking to Sister Burns so long, but when that day shall come, she tell them she don't know me. But that is the reality behind the appearance. What we are doing need to be in accordance to what God have instructed us to do. And no matter how difficult this might be to swallow, it is the reality. Many of us are doing things for self-recognition and self-praise, and not because God have commanded us to do it. But thank God that there is grace. Thank God that even though we might fall his direction, he still is calling us back. Is about him. Everything that we say is about him. And whatever, wherever we go, individuals should be seeing Christ and not us. The reality behind the appearance is something that each and every one of us needs to take into consideration. We need to ensure that we are guided and led by the Holy Spirit. We need to ensure that our relationship with God is ever so strong that when he give a command and when we go out, people don't see Elder Jerry, people don't see Sister Angela, but they see God in what we do. Proverbs chapter 19 verse 21 says, many are the plans in person's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose to prevail. Everything that we do, my friends, need to be God's purpose. Everything that we do, my friends, needs to be God's command. Because we are in the final days. And if we get it right now, when the judgment shall come, we will hear, depart from me, I know you not. What is the reality behind your appearance today is the question. And I hope and pray that it will be a response that I am guided and directed by God. And everything that I do and say is as God command and not as self. This morning, somebody is contemplating on this question, the reality behind the appearance. And I pray that if we are not in accordance with that reality, that we get it right. Because there is no time like the present to be under the anointing of God. Oh, my friends, there's many things that we can say, but I challenge you today to ensure that your reality is accordance to God guidance. Shall we pray, most high loving Father? Thank you for your word, and thank you for your reminder. Father, we pray, oh God, the individuals who are contemplating this question even now. We pray, oh God, that your Holy Spirit will flow through our lives, oh God, and ensure that everything we do and say will be as you command. Father, we pray for your continued blessing and joy, Gospel Radio. And we pray, oh God, that whatever is said and done will be done according to your will. Amen. I pray now. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.